It's a big unit, dude. It won't be a cheap effort. Yeah, you've got a shit ton of plants right now, but that's like a drop in the ocean to what potentially, you know, where you could take the business.
This is all in tying in with the launch that we would like to hit. The USA launch that everybody has been asking me for.
We're low on funds. I'm trying to, you know, complete this project with the money that is in the bank, just being totally transparent with you.
We're laughing, but it's not funny anymore.
It's getting to the point where it's getting a bit like, oh shit, isn't it?
I feel like this thing needs to be done in like a week or 2 weeks.
It's another one of these situations where I'm a little bit more paranoid than you, and there could be ulterior motives going on.
It's bullshit. They asked for the proof.
I can't believe that.
That's a new
is
one,
that
like
even that? Tea? Like, does the shops know that, honestly?
I don't know.
Do I carry on going as I'm going and max out or whatever else, or do I take the leap of faith and then just do this seemingly absolutely crazy thing?
You haven't got a choice.
In terms of walking into that nursery, even after seeing all the Thai nurseries, I have never seen shit like that, ever.
That was really bad, is that, isn't it?
No, that's 10 out of 10 bad.
That compromises really bad.
As a company, that compromises my entire reputation.
Correct, yeah.
It's not even professional, although obviously it is professional, but it feels like there is an air of...
There's something else at play.
You.
It feels weird to me, not selling in full season right now. And I know everyone is looking at me going, wow, you have a shop full of stock, what's going on? Obviously now you know what's been going on the whole time.
I don't know what's waiting for me at the other end. Even given how bad it is right now, the hate at the other end could be 10 times worse.
So it's finally time for me to come clean, I guess. Those of you that do not know me, hello, my name is Kaylee Allen. I run a rare houseplant channel here on YouTube, and I also own a shop, the Rare Plant Shop, which just earlier this year turned one. Those of you that already know me, it would be fair to say that over the past year, most of the year actually, I haven't been putting out the usual content that I would put out onto YouTube. Welcome to yet another repot with me. And welcome to another plant haul. I've been asked about this many times and I usually just make my excuses and I say that I'm really, really busy with the shop, but I've never really divulged why. I guess it's been kind of a secret in that sense. So it is finally time to share my journey with you over the past 6 months plus of behind the scenes of the shop, and in some cases behind the scenes with me as well. It has taken many, many months to get to this point, but I'm finally ready. It's time to expand. It's time for the shop to become something bigger and better. Earlier this year, I made the difficult decision to close doors on the shop in order to transform it completely into what it currently is today. This isn't just my journey. I have had somebody with me the entire time. I asked Ben to be part of this because, quite frankly, I can't make a jump like this on my own. So Ben has joined me throughout the entire thing and he will continue to join me throughout the journey of this shop. And let me tell you, it has been a wild ride to get to where we are today. But I'm really glad to have experienced every second of it because it has changed me as a person. For that, I'm really grateful. So the best way to show you the path that I have chosen to take is to start from the very beginning.
Hi,
here we are, a la barbecue, just waiting on Ben right now to bring a notepad because obviously, you know, we forgot. Standard.
It's gonna take a long time to cook all that one barbecue, dude. That'd be all
right. Right, sweating before we even start.
This is what I did last time.
Yeah.
I went to Beach with Kids.
Yep.
Fucking left the cardboard on, didn't I? I left the cardboard on.
There's cardboard inside it that you light.
There is, but there's also a cardboard tray around it as well, look.
Oh my god.
I left that on thinking it was part and parcel of it. Having never used a disposable barbecue previously. Obviously, there's a big warning on the side that I didn't see. That sort of set fire as well.
For fuck's sake, dude. We've got some shit in here, though. Mainly meat, am I right?
What happens if you don't like? Always going
to
get some petrol. Got freshening implements for you.
Right.
You'd be right there, wouldn't you?
What do you mean I? I'm not doing shit.
All right, I'm in control.
This is how the partnership's going to work, dude.
Is it?
You cook the food.
I cook, you eat it.
And I eat the fucking food.
Right, okay. Well, there you go, there's your drink.
Also, we shouldn't be getting pissed, by the way, and I don't know how that's going to work, so can you at least not get me into any trouble?
Really?
Maybe.
You're not advertising, are you?
Possibly. I don't know.
So this unit...
So I've gathered you here today, Ben.
Have you?
Because.
Gathered me?
In this random fucking corner.
Forced me.
I haven't forced you. So you've seen the unit, to put it out there.
Yes, I have.
Because I needed your advice on whether it was even going to do the job. Because, the reason why you're here, I don't have experience in this shit. Because I grow plants, obviously, in a house environment, right? Mm. You, however.
Yes, boy.
Do not necessarily. You grow shit in an outdoor nursery.
Indeed.
I know you've got experience with this sort of shit. You know how to heat things, you know all that. So I kind of need your help with it. Because seriously, beyond getting the unit, I know I've got to heat it. I know I've got to make sure it's good humidity.
What else is it?
This is what you tell me, dude.
Exactly. What am I here for? I'm here for beer and barbecue.
But I want you to help me.
Indeed. It's a big unit, dude.
My concern is the height of the ceiling.
It is very concerning, isn't it? What is it? It's 12 by 12, 12 metres by 12 metres. And then the height of it is, it's easily that again, isn't it? I think just the sheer volume of volume is going to be an issue.
Sheer volume of volume.
The sheer volume.
Damn, that's a lot of volume.
It's going to be a scary prospect over winter, I think.
Yeah.
You know, it won't be a cheap effort. You're going to have to sell a lot of plants to get it to that point. Quite sure. Yeah.
Obviously, I'm a shop at the minute, but I do see this as being more of like, not a nursery and not a shop. So it's kind of in between. Mm. Like if I upgraded the unit after this, I would be telling you I'd be making a nursery, right? The best way I could describe it is warehouse/nursery. So it needs to run kind of like a nursery, except there are some other things that I want to be able to do.
Okay,
hit
me.
I totally need your help because we need to build some walls.
Walls. We need to build walls.
Yes. So.
But at the minute, there's an office in there already.
Yeah, but I don't. That's not.
That's not good enough.
So above that office,
yeah.
I asked the letting agent and he said you could build on top of it, right? So what if I built like a studio on the top of it? And I could either use it as just a studio, or I could use it as like studio/photographing the plants because I need somewhere to do that and that's gonna be a nightmare. I don't know.
Wall is needed.
Yeah, but but also there is something I've always wanted to do. Now I have a lot of like mother plants, right? Sort of. I have some larger plants that I've been growing out.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that Enid from NSA has this awesome kind of living wall, right?
Oh, shit.
So I thought, what if, right? I don't know if it's possible, so this could be airy fairy, but I just want to put it out there so you know kind of where I'm at. What if we made a massive living wall? I don't know where. I don't know, because I can't imagine where it would go.
That would be fucking awesome.
It would be amazing.
Sold.
Okay.
It's a pretty big undertaking, isn't it?
No, I'm a bit worried.
Isn't it?
I mean, I haven't signed the lease yet, but like, let's be real, I'm not backing out.
It's one of them things, you're at the little junction, aren't you? You're at a fork in your business where you either need to take that step and do it, or you carry on doing what you're doing and stay as you are, I suppose.
Yeah, it's like, do I carry on going as I'm going and max out or whatever else, or do I take the leap of faith and then just do this seemingly absolutely crazy thing?
You want my opinion?
No.
If you are going to open to the USA, like you say you want to, you haven't got a choice. because you haven't got the space required for the number of plants that you're going to be able to, or want to be able to, or need to be able to supply.
No.
You just haven't. Yeah, you've got a shit ton of plants right now, but that's like a drop in the ocean to what, you know, potentially, you know, where you could take the business.
Oh dear. So, dude, are you hungry? Well, you can slow cook beef and shit, can't you?
Yes, there's slow cooking and then there's no cooking, dude. Dude, I'm pleased to be outside.
This is true.
And we still managed to be completely avoidant of all civilization. Have you shown everyone where
I'll
we actually are?
I'll give a bit of a pan, shall I?
In the car park of the old Kaylee's office building.
And we may or may not have hijacked for a bit of a picnic table.
This point.
For the picnic. Oh my god, I'm embarrassed, dude.
It's alright. Listen, sausages take a long time.
Okay, I'm embarrassed.
Sausages take ages. Don't worry about that.
No, they don't.
Yeah, they do.
But you know, I want mine like totally charred, right?
Yeah.
Like, I want it to be like, I want to eat the charcoal.
That's fine. We will do that.
There's no other way to do a sausage on barbecue.
We've got until 5 o'clock.
What do you mean we're going until 5 o'clock? It's like 2 o'clock now.
Yes, 3 hours to char it.
Happy if I have to wait 3 hours for a charred sausage,
yeah,
I'm going to do it. Oh, that's something we should probably quickly mention.
Oh, is it what?
I don't know how long this is going to take to do. They haven't told me when I can have the lease. They've said end of June slash July. And it's now like nearly mid-May. So dude, I think I mentioned this to you anyway, but for the sake of everyone else, I've been told that there's no electricity yet.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what the delay is.
Mm.
The unit is built, the unit is ready, the unit is snatched, whatever. Mm-hmm. I can't have it yet because no
right.
electricity.
So this is a COVID issue.
I would say so.
That's a beer.
Honestly, it is. It really is. Be prepared for serious mess. It's not good. Oh, dude. Yeah.
Overexposed.
Will it not go down?
It's getting there. Fuck, turn them lights off.
Better.
Yeah.
Well, I was going to hang these up, but there's no point because I'm moving so shortly. It's like, well, shit, I'll just run them here because I don't want to hang them there yet. Voice message from Pam.
Okay.
I literally thought it was your shop. What do they mean? They don't understand how it could be this. That is fucking bananas. You know what? So go the tribulations of being the trendsetter, my dear. So it's, I fear this is just a thing that you are just gonna fucking deal with forever, but go to bed, you know, at night knowing that you did it first, motherfucker.
Fuck, dude. Okay, so
savage,
I may as well explain the tea just really quickly. So Pam messaged me like, I don't know, 2-3 days ago, something like that. I know you kind of know this. I'm talking to Ben behind the camera.
Who's Pam?
I don't want to necessarily name the Pam.
Oh, okay, fair. All right.
It's fucking Pam, guys. Okay? There's your clue. So she messaged me a couple of days ago basically saying, yo, have you started a new shop? You know, there's this shop that's basically... I thought it was you, you know, like the shop followed me this morning on Instagram. Hey, I thought it was you because it looked kind of like your logo, only not. It was kind of flipped over and it was white, yada, yada, yada. Is it you? Is it not? It's funny because they tagged your shop's tag in their shit. So she kind of messaged me and told me about it. And well, basically I have a trademark on my shop. So they're in violation of it. So that's the tea. So we're talking about shit, let's just be honest, shops kind of do it, but this shop, a lot of shops do it and they take my logo and they make it similar, but this shop just went that little bit too far. So I'm kind of dealing with that at the minute, so.
It's kind of like your branding, isn't it?
No, it is though.
It looks the same, doesn't it, really?
But like, I'm not being funny. Before my shop came along, no one really bothered to do the whole black and white, you know, non-green thing. And it's like, since I've done it, everybody's got to do it, which is fine, but like, at least take the time to make your logo look nothing like mine. At least try and innovate, create your own thing. That's the whole point of making business, right? You innovate.
Indeed.
It just pisses me off. But that's the tea anyway. So that's what she's talking about. And I might have blurred out half of that so you couldn't fucking hear it. Because it was rough. Ben got to hear it.
It was a bit savage.
Ben got to hear it. That was savage as fuck, dude. But that's Pam, so that's why I love Pam.
We do,
so.
We like Pam, don't we?
There you go, that's my week.
So how warm is it in here now?
Oh my gosh, get right in on that.
Get right in on that?
It feels like it's much higher humidity. I'm sweat. Look, I've walked in. I don't know if you can see that. Just rub my head. It's fucking wet.
Am I actually dripping that much? It's kind of hot in here, isn't it? I think it's bollocks, humidity sensor, mate. I'm telling you.
I think it's looking greener now.
Yeah, look at it. Fuck.
Oh god, it looks good. Look how sexy it looks on camera.
Shit, it's gonna take me 10 minutes to walk to the back so I can actually see the top. No, I'm still going, dude.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yes. There you go. Well, wait a minute, though, because it's not just that, is it? It's that as well. So that.
Oh, we'll get this.
Yeah.
And this.
Yes.
Would you like to hear my plans? I'm out of breath. Yes, that tiny little skip. Fuck me. I haven't fully decided yet on what I want to do, right? So you can be my soundboard. So I'm thinking mirrored glass, but I don't know if I want my logo here or not. I can't decide. I might just put my logo inside. I don't know. Top glass, obviously keep it. No one cares. It's not like anyone can come in, so I don't need the logo there. It's more of a just, I'll just put my fucking logo on it kind of thing. Mm. But I know I definitely want mirrored glass. That's like no doubt in my mind.
Look, I've only just got there. I've got the top of your head at the bottom. It's massive.
I don't know if all of these have been taken yet. By the time you guys see this, these will all be rented out and this will be like totally different by the time you see this. But at the minute, they're just finishing work on them. Like as I said before, there's no electricity in here yet, so. Mm. There she is.
There she is.
This is my new baby.
With a bit of luck.
For the next however long, yeah. Ooh. It's just enough to be like a hybrid between a shop and something a little bit more.
Yeah.
Someone's probably watching this now going, Kaylee, that is extra as fuck.
I'll not be funny, mate. It is. When you see yourself stood next to the door, dude.
This is just enough.
I'm not being funny, dude. Oh. Shit. You know what I'm saying? If the floor space were the size of the door, it would have been enough.
Yeah.
And that's just the door.
It's going to be a bumpy ride, dude. Something just tells me. How do we make this empty shell into the red plant shop?
Work.
Work. Said it. Work. So it's actually now a month later than what you last saw. I think we last filmed on like 17th of May, I think I checked. We've got the keys, but we don't have power yet. So we can actually begin some work on this unit today, but we're kind of limited because we don't actually have any electricity or any water. So I'll leave that open for you. So it's full of shit in here. Case in point over here. That's because we're barbecuing later, by the way, which you will probably see. But generally, this room here is going to be front of house, kind of like reception, would you say? Kind of not. I think I'm probably going to have a desk over here, probably a filing cabinet or some way of keeping paperwork behind here. Probably table and chairs in here, just like a little two-seater thing so I can like eat and whatnot when I'm working. In this corner here. Stay tuned, because I swear to God I'm going to die trying, but I'm going to put a vending machine right here. I haven't bought one yet, but I will find one and I will place it right here. There's no real reason why I want a vending machine. I just thought it'd be cool. So it's kind of like a personal mission when I'm doing this unit up that I put a vending machine in. So that's 100% going there. So watch this space for that. I will do my best to show you in here. I've got a little light to show you because obviously there's no power yet. This is the kitchen. There is literally nothing to tell you about this kitchen other than it's a kitchen. It's white gloss. There's no appliances in. There's no fridge. There's nothing like that. I don't really know what I would put in there. I'm thinking kettle, maybe microwave. I don't know. Dude, no, so much bread. I don't need that much bread in my life. In here, we have the rather bleak looking toilet, which I mean, I need a mirror on that wall, but other than that, don't know how you jazz that up, but
it's not nice as well.
It's a toilet. And in here, you have the shell of what will be the shop. You can see, if you just pan past me, you can probably get a feel of what it's like in here. Yeah, so there is some shit. So here we've got new humidifier. Don't be put off by how small it is. Trust me.
Shit.
Where's
gonna fill this room in about 20 seconds.
Yes, boy. It's like I can't see my feet with all the fire.
That's a bollocks, isn't it?
That's me building shelving 10 minutes ago. We're actually filming this twice because I filmed this yesterday of taking you guys around, but it turns out it was stupidly overexposed, so.
Is it too bright or is it okay?
It's, well, you're just glowing.
I'm kind of doing it again to make sure that we can actually show you what it's like before it gets done up, obviously. This has been a work in progress for 2 days now.
No, it hasn't.
Yes, it has. I'm putting a ladder on top of here because up here I want it to be my studio. We're basically somehow gonna build like kind of like a fake living room kind of idea that I'm gonna film in. We have these awesome steps that I'm in the middle of spraying black that you will probably see me do right now.
Although there is nothing wrong with it being red, this is the red plant shop, and around here, if it can come in black, then
These are red. I don't want them red. I want them black. So sanding them down, spraying them black. Huge big shutters. They will be electronic, but right now they're not. This is the special part, and this doesn't look like anything right now. This just looks like a wall, but this is so special. I can't fucking even begin to describe, because what we're going to attempt to do is put a living wall here. And I think we're going to go up, what, 3.5 meters maybe? And we are hoping to make something that I saw when we were going around a garden center like a couple of weeks ago. We were in somewhere like a big open garden center, and they had tree ferns, and they had loads of tree ferns framing this big amazing kind of like water feature. It almost looked like a giant door frame. It kind of like rained down the water. So what I really want to do is have this living wall somehow integrate a water feature. But that's what we're gonna try and do. It's gonna be sick. This is why I've been buying all these massive aroids. There you go. This is why I couldn't actually tell you on videos. This is why I'm actually buying all the big aroids. What am I going to do with it, you might ask? Well, I'm not going to tell you. It's kind of a secret at the minute, but I promise you, you will find out in due course. Just hang in there and you'll see what I end up doing with this absolute beast. It's for this massive wall right here. And I can only hope it works, dude. Otherwise, we are fucked. I don't know what I'm going to do with all them aroids if that doesn't work. So you're looking at the shell of what will be the shop, right? We showed them the nice skylights. The free 99 natural light that we get. I'm so excited. I can't. It's gonna be a lot of work. We're gonna have to do a shit ton, and that's without power. Also, check it. This will be my attire for the next 2 months, probably. I think that's it. I think we should get to work. Oh, barbecue in a bit, I think. Ooh. Hell yeah. That's all they're ever gonna see us do is barbecue, dude. Okay. Acting stupid, but being dumb. Maybe just a little bit foolish, but I feel so young. Drunk, I've never seen you clearer than now. We're flying high, floating somewhere up in the clouds. So this is probably about half of the boxes that have got to go out for launch. It's not fully finished, but I think we've kind of had our fill today. I'm just so tired all the time. I know I say this all the time, but I just don't stop being tired.
I don't know what to say. I'm just so tired. Oh, wasted. City lights are shining so bright. All these empty faces. We don't care about them tonight. Can you feel it? Almost like I don't know if it's real. Cause when we're doing our thing with the wheels don't stop turning. I know we're acting stupid.
I'm always yawning every time you turn this fucking camera on.
You're working hard. You've done a shit ton of
Does it look like I've done a shit ton?
Yeah, it was fucking brilliant.
Yeah, yeah, it's all right.
Right, so this little money eye that came up on Facebook, currently it's bid at 1,200 quid. I think they're pretty slow growing, that's the only problem, so okay. It's not going to be a quick turnaround if we were to get it.
Understandably.
Now the issue is that somebody's trying to swap plus money an Adam Sony eye mint, which, looking at pictures to me,
is it actually mint, dude, or is it a fucking virus? Because
dude, honestly,
50-50, what?
Yeah, very 50-50. It's got distortion relief and shit on there. I think that it's just a
you know, a full-on virus bloody plant illness, which, in which case, you know, if it's mosaic virus...
Then it's worth zero.
Which makes sense, because this is probably where they picked it up from, because, you know, the variation is a weird structure. I can't really tell what it is. It's not mosaic. It's, you know, it's, one, it's that ver- probably that virus that's going around, but it's got shit on it. Well, that's not the point, because if they believe it's mint, then they're going to think that there's mint value attached to the mint. Therefore, you know, your 1,000 plus the mint, it's going to take it well above sort of a 2 gram purchase price, isn't it?
Yeah.
And there's a couple of other people on there that, you know, are known for buying and selling and shit. So these guys want it probably as much, if not as much as us. Depending.
I want it too, though.
Now, because we're doing this, and it's draining our
pound notes. We're not strapped for cash. We're being careful with cash, right?
Yes. Well, we're trying to, but
we're trying but failing. It's not working.
I know.
We still haven't budgeted for this place yet, which is fucking ridiculous. And everyone's probably screaming at us right now.
Yeah. Well, we're sort of buying what we need and doing it as we're doing it, aren't we?
We're buying the stuff that we have no choice to buy. Mm. And then...
That's the rest, I think, will be
budget. Yeah, because this is kind of like beyond budget. We have to get it, so...
Exactly, for candles and shit, you know.
Candles?
Yeah, to make it look fancy.
I'm not buying candles, bro. It's a fucking fire.
Your room look fancy.
Dad, I'm not buying candles.
Oh, fuck.
My dad would kick the fuck off. So, Il Mani, aye?
Yeah.
So we wouldn't get it for two?
I don't think we'll get it for two.
It cannot be worth more than 2.5. Surely.
It depends how much value they put on this add-on Sony, which, you know, to me is probably worthless, but people are probably going to sort of say, well, maybe that's 1,500 quid worth.
I was going to say, what have they bid up? Want that 1.2?
They've bid 1,000 euros plus.
1,000
euros plus an add-on Sony, or somebody else has also bid 1.2.
Do we want it? Otherwise, this is a pointless discussion.
Well, you want it, don't you? It's a nice looking plant.
It's nice.
It's another fucking holy grail plants, isn't it? That...
Yeah. Well, obviously we can keep doing launches, but and no one's going to know this at the time, but the reason why I haven't been doing big launches is to keep, obviously, the stock to propagate here, right?
Mm.
So you won't know this till right now, but this is why we haven't been doing big launches. I have all the stock in the world, but I just don't want to sell it.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Because I need to propagate from it.
Yeah. Well, what about
but that? I can... I just don't want to.
Okay, how about if we just pop up on an obliquer up for sale?
We could do that.
That'll, you know...
I don't actually know how many I have, but...
Chuck a few quid in the bank for, you know, reserve, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we could do that. Pop two up for sale and just buy the Il Mani. It looks like we got some mail. I wouldn't usually film this, obviously, but I think there might be one or two plants in here. I know there's definitely one I can see by looking at it. My scissors are absolutely fucked. So I'm just gonna open whatever it is. Oh, wall charger, so I can actually start charging my camera batteries because I'm struggling a lot.
Right, first class medium parcel, but it's light. What is that?
I'm expecting a couple of cuttings, but one of them has been lost. Oh, so one of them has been lost in the mail for 2 weeks plus, and I think it was a rooted Hoya cutting. We'll see if that arrives. I honestly don't know what's coming. Oh, wait! No, these aren't cuttings. This is something else. But it is a plant. Okay. Now I get it. Yeah. Okay. So, plant one. We have got this off eBay maybe 3 days ago, something like that, over the weekend anyway, in the midst of all the filming. So this is a really cute variegated Alocasia Amazonica. This might not be anything new, but I thought I would get it for the shop and see if I can propagate it and everything else. It's quite cute. It's come in really good condition. Loving that. They're a bit weird. I haven't even had a regular Amazonica before. So this is like my first Amazonica and it's all weird. If that's the newest leaf there, that's got plenty of variegation on it. That's what you want. Check it. That's one there. It's not bad. Okay, so that's one plant. I forgot all about ordering that plant. That's a little coffee, like, wagon that pulls up outside. And it's incredibly irritating. There it is. So this box here should in fact be a cutting, because I'm kind of into Hoyer at the minute. So I may have ordered some Hoyer cuttings that I don't fully understand what I'm doing with. But I ordered this little guy. Ooh, okay. So this here is Hoyer AH074, I think. It's kind of silvery. And I think the leaves are different every time. So although you might think this looks like a grey ghost now, the variegation can kind of change a lot. So it's like this really cool silver speckled number. It's very nice, I have to say. I just have to work out now how to root this. So that's her. Isn't she cool? She's massive as well. So I'm gonna get to rooting that now. And then I guess it's time to get on with my work, because I'm working right now. Hell yeah. Yes.
Right, dude, so it's eventful today, isn't it?
It is very eventful today, yeah. It's 20 past 8. Well, the rundown is this lady put Neil Manny and I up saying, here it is, make me an offer. I will choose the offers at, well, basically 9 pm tonight, which is 40 minutes, and I may or may not sell to the highest offer. So there's no guarantee we're going to get it, but bidding currently stands at what?
1600.
So, real quick, we need to come up with a number that we are happy to go to.
Well, based on the pictures, there's quite a few nodes. What do we say, 4? If we're going to propagate it, sell it on, you know, later rather than sooner. They're probably going to go for 2.5 in the right area, easily.
True.
Yeah.
It's worth that much.
So it's worth that. Definitely worth 2.5.
What do you think we should go to? Do we go up to? Well, what's our maximum number and then what is our tactic?
Right,
maximum
okay.
Number, is it 2?
Yeah, it's a lot of cash to outlay on, you know, a potential loss if it gets lost in the post, if it, you know, if anything goes to shit with it. We don't necessarily know how well rooted it is, don't forget either. It looks a nice plant, looks healthy, looks like it's growing.
So 2,000 is max?
I think 2,000 is max.
So providing this bid doesn't shift, how, so say it's at 1,006, do we add on 100, do we add on 200?
Looking at the auction now, if this other chap puts on another 100, then what I'll do, I'll pop 25 on, just try and psych him out and see if he will only put 25 on after that. I think when it comes up real close to 9 o'clock, we'll just smash on another, like, 150 or something like that. Just try and keep it low. Correct, yeah, exactly, yeah.
Okay.
All right, last few seconds, so we'll see how we get on, but we've got another, what, half an hour?
Yeah.
And we're waiting for the tea.
Well,
good timing.
We're waiting for food.
Yeah,
you tea. Can't say tea because it sounds like fucking drama, dude. So we'll just wait and see what happens just before 9 o'clock, like 2 minutes to 9, right? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Bid on here, we're going to bid on the, if I bid on here, then we can bid. Oh, yes, it's popped up, but it's not popped up, not even popped up on the phone.
My phone won't fucking refresh, really.
It's not getting spammed, is it? Is it linked to the post? Okay. Oh God, everyone's waiting till the last minute to rock up. Well, okay. Shit, son, this is going over too.
Yeah,
I reckon it's going over too.
Someone else is typing.
Oh God, what time is it now? It's 2 minutes to go. Oh, fuck me, okay. How are you gonna know when it ends? Dude, you can't do that. That's not enough. Dude, it's not enough. Keep looking because reacts are coming up quicker than we can see them.
It's 9.
It's what?
It's 9.
Do we get it?
Well, I mean, I got it.
Fuck you.
But I've just outbid you by 50. Theoretically.
Do you want to refresh that real quick?
I've refreshed mine. It's like 9 o'clock. Do you know what I mean? Yours is shit. It's, look, it's gone.
Mine is shit. Well, refresh
know,
the page.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Just refresh the page. Do it. We are.
I'd be pissed if the
me too.
Right, we've won that.
We've got, one of us has got it, dude, or someone's writing.
Doesn't matter, it's 9 o'clock.
18:30, he's still going. He's still fucking going. Dude. This is against the rules because it's now 1 minute past 9, and this is evidence that it's 1 minute past 9. Uh-huh. You can't do that, boy. You can't do that. What does it say? I think you can look. Can you look on a phone on the actual metadata of a comment?
Because
I think. I'm sure this has happened to me in an auction before and it's had to be.
How?
I don't know, but I'm sure admins can actually look at the comment and they get like the proper timestamp on the comment.
Yeah, okay.
They should see that his is late. Because ours should have gone in before 9, really.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
he put his on like 9:01, isn't he?
Yeah, you can't do that. Why is he smiling as if he's wrong? This does not make me happy. Dude. Seller there. I have to blow the shit out of this. According to my Facebook, Ben Byron was the last one to bid. Yes. You won it, dude.
Yeah.
Look, he's trying to... Is he trying to argue the point? Sorry if I'm in your way, dude. I've got to get it on camera. Is he trying to say that it's... Yeah, okay. We've got that though, right, dude?
Last one to bid before the deadline.
I know, but that guy's like, you know...
I know, is he?
He's trying to say no, mine should be valid, but that's not how bidding on Facebook works, right?
No.
So now the deal is, even though we've won the quote-unquote auction, which isn't an auction, the seller doesn't actually have to sell this plant to us, correct?
Yeah.
So we're now just waiting to hear if she wants to accept the offer, which is the weirdest purchase I've ever made, but it's a wild ride, dude.
Yeah, it is a bit, isn't it?
Totally.
Mm. Gotta be saying, I'd be pretty fucked off if she turns around and says she ain't selling it now.
Yeah. I'm not gonna love this. So we all agree that Ben Byron is the winner. Yes, boy. I think they're right, it's a best offer, but it has to be before 9.
It says before 9 on the thing, a best
show
offer.
Show me. Where is it?
9 o'clock in the evening.
I will stop collecting offers at 9 o'clock.
Correct. Therefore.
Therefore.
Best offer before 9.
Which is your offer.
Yeah.
And just to clarify, Warren, we fully know that the seller could choose to not sell the plant to us.
Oh, of course.
Just obviously clarifying this for people watching this.
Yeah.
We are aware of this. It's just more the point that if people just keep going after 9, it's
correct.
Like, where does it end, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know. She must have worked out by now if she wants to sell it, surely.
She's happy with the price, I suspect.
Yes.
Okay, so she's happy with the price. And what I suppose we can do, if she accepts that offer, we can sort of say, well, you know, if you do want an oblique plus a bit of cash to make up for it, up to 1,800, we'd be happy to do that.
What, instead of money? I thought she wanted money.
Yeah, she does want money, but, you know, no. Right, let's just leave this shit now, because there's nothing we can do, so...
We'll leave it, and then when we find out something...
Yeah, go play it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, right. Cool. Maybe she'll message me or some shit, I don't know, so...
The people.
Alright, so it's now... What time is it? Fucking quarter to 11 now. So she's just come back and announced the winner. So if I want to just read it to you. It's like, what the fuck?
Dude, my heart... Like, I feel sick. I shouldn't feel this sick about a plant.
Yeah, okay, well, we've got... Okay, guys, sorry for keeping you waiting, but I think you all understand my stressful situation. All right, thank you for your offers. So I decided to take an offer, a blanket and cash from Ben. Yay!
Yes!
Congratulations, Ben and Kaylee.
That's awesome.
That's spot on.
How much cash?
Well, it'd be 800, wouldn't it?
800 plus.
800 plus quid. Happy days.
Oh, dude, you made me think. Oh, God.
Yes, boy.
You literally just said to me,
yeah,
put the TV off, I'm going to film you. And you said, like, we've had news back, and you didn't tell me anything.
No.
That's nasty, bro.
Yes, it made you feel a little bit sick.
I did actually feel sick.
I thought you did. That was the plan. There you go.
Oh, it's the tensest shit. How tense is that?
If you're going to tell me that we're not getting this box, I'm going to lose it, dude.
So, somebody sent me something this morning about, you remember the pink Congo?
Mm-hmm.
Like last year?
Yeah.
Somebody sent me something early this morning of somebody else saying on Instagram, pink Congo wasn't a scam, find me one source that's not Facebook and I'll take this down. I reposted it saying, lol, repot with me on Friday, proof coming up.
So they think that I'm going to do a video on them?
Is this going to be a fucking... Seriously? Seriously, is this going to be a thing where I'm... Okay, so, the meeting that is the budget. This is all in tying in with the launch, the USA launch that everybody has been asking me for. I did want to do it earlier this year, but I think we both just decided, since we're doing this, let's make sure we do this, get it right.
Do it right.
We can use it to launch and get a bigger launch out of it.
Get a shit ton of plants.
Dude, that's an entire corridor.
Yes.
That's not exactly space in the map, do you know what I mean?
Quite a few, isn't there?
This is a box I didn't expect to arrive. This is actually the box of fucking Florida ghosts that should not be here right now. I don't know if we could pull it off, quite honestly, so I'm saying this and no one might ever see me saying this, but